So we are back to our lesson, that is components of food. I hope everyone understood yesterday's session. We were studying about components of food, that is second lesson of your science subject, right? So let me revise a little bit thing that whatever we have discussed yesterday's session, right? So we were talking about food, right? So that food is basically very important for all living organisms. Why it is very necessary? Because it helps us to grow, it keeps our body very healthy, it keeps our body physically and mentally very fit, right? And even it helps us to grow. So for these all purpose, food is very very important, and it is acting as a very very important component, right? But there is a one thing which is present in a food. That is only the main thing which is helping food to make this all works correctly, right? So which is that food? Okay, that we call it as a, which is present in a food, that is nothing but nutrients. Okay, so today we will discuss about nutrients. So what those nutrients are? Nutrients are those, they are components of food. What are components of food? Nutrients are components of food. Okay, here I'll write in short manner, components of food. Okay, I'll write nutrients are components of food, which will help. Which will help for what purpose? It will help for nourishment and growth of our body and even maintenance of our life. So remember that nutrients are those substances which will provide nourishment, growth and maintenance of our life. So these components are called as what? Nutrients. Understood? So that nutrients are present in some of food which I have given below here. For example, milk, cheese, fish, fruits, meat. These are some examples where nutrient is present in all food items, right? Now next you can see, yes, next you can see which are those nutrients. Already we have discussed these all in yesterday's session. So which are those nutrients? First one is carbohydrates, proteins, calcium, vitamins, minerals, fats. But there are some food items which are rich in these specific nutritious components. But it is not necessary that one food is rich. It may be rich in multiple nutrients, right? And here you can see milk is not only rich in calcium, but it will also give us carbohydrates. So in this way, the food items are containing what? Multiple nutrient. But today we will discuss which those particular food items contain these all nutrients. Alright. Okay. Let us discuss that nutrients one. Yes. First we will begin with the nutrient that is called carbohydrate. Right. So here you can see the picture of carbohydrate. So carbohydrate is a component of food which is mainly a energy giving component. So carbohydrate is called as what? Energy giving component. So carbohydrates, they mainly provide energy to our body, right? Here some examples where the glucose is present in the form of starch and sugar. So carbohydrate is present in the form of what all things? Starch and sugar, right? So when you are running, when you are jumping, when you are studying, or when you are walking very fast, that time you require energy, right? So that energy from where you are getting? You are getting that energy from carbohydrates. Where that carbohydrate present in your food item, right? So remember that the carbohydrate is present in the form of what? Starch and sugar, right? Okay. Next, you see, we have mainly two types of carbohydrates. One is simple carbohydrate and one more complex carbohydrate. See here, simple carbohydrate. Simple carbohydrates are those which can digest easily in your body, right? But the complex carbohydrates are those which will take little bit time. First, it will digest into simple carbohydrate. Then it will be absorbed by blood. Then after you'll get what? Energy from what? That carbohydrates. So we have two types of carbohydrate. Which are those? Here somewhere I'll write. Simple carbohydrate and complex carbohydrate. Alright. And now we will see some examples for simple carbohydrate. Yes. So simple carbohydrates are those which digested quickly and thus provides us what? Instant energy. And here you can see some of edible simple carbohydrates such as starch, fructose, cellulose, glucose and lactose. And here some food items which I have shown on the screen is like corn and potato. They are rich in starch and fructose. Fructose, they are obtained from the fruits. So that is why the name suggests you like fructose, fro. So the name is starting from fro. So that fructose you are getting from what? Fruits. Next, cellulose you are getting from plants. And glucose, you can see that glucose you are getting from honey. And next one is milk. That milk you are easily obtaining from lactose. Here one thing you can remember that milk is not only rich in calcium but also it will give us carbohydrates. And one more important thing is that carbohydrates, they are chemically formed by what? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So by these three chemical or the components, the carbohydrate is forming. That is why we are naming it as a carbohydrate. Okay, carbon, carbohydrates, that is hydrogen, and one more component that is present in carbohydrate, that is oxygen. So this is all about what? Simple carbohydrate. Now let us discuss some complex carbohydrate in which all food item it is present, right? Okay, now let us discuss about complex carbohydrates. Which type of carbohydrates? Complex carbohydrates. Why I am calling this as a complex carbohydrates? Just because it will take a little bit time to digest. First, it will broken down into simple carbohydrates. Then that simple sugars will be called it as a glucose, right? Now, that simple sugars will be absorbed by blood. Then after, you'll get energy from that sugars. And here, starch is an example for what? Complex carbohydrates. And these starch, you'll be obtaining from some of food items such as here you can see on the screen. That is, first is rice. So the complex carbohydrate you can see in starch, but that starch you are obtaining from one example, that is rice. And one more example I'll show you, that is wheat. Okay, so wheat in wheat you will get easily starch as a carbohydrate. And some more examples like potatoes. Okay, in potato also you will get starch, that is carbohydrate. Maize and sugar. So these are what some examples of carbohydrate, where carbohydrate is present in the form of starch. That starch will be obtained from these all food items. Let me show you once again which are those. That is maize and sugar cane, potatoes and sweet potatoes, wheat, rice. These are what some examples of complex carbohydrate. All right. Okay, but how you will understand that specific food or any food items that is rich in carbohydrate, or else there is a presence of carbohydrate, how you will understand that? So for that purpose I have an activity where you can observe it clearly, how you can test the presence of carbohydrate in any given food items, right? So let us begin with that.
Children, now let us test the presence of starch in different food items like boiled rice, potato, salt and sugar. In order to check this, we need iodine solution. It is dark brownish yellow in color. To test the presence of starch, you have to pour 2-3 drops of iodine solution in each food item, in sugar, salt, boiled rice and potato. I have poured iodine solution. Now you can observe the color change. In boiled rice and potato, you can see blue-black color. That means it contains starch. But in salt and sugar, there is no color change. That itself tells that it does not contain starch in it.